Hello students, welcome online classes for the first year students of Kakatiya Graduate Junior College Narsampet. Now today class number 9, here this is the second topic in mathematics B paper. So that is change of axis or transformation of axis. Here students, so in these previous classes, so we completed the first topic locus and this is the second one. The change of axis. Here in this geometry, so change of axis or transformation of axis. Here transformation of axis means these are the two types. One is the translation of axis and the rotation of axis. Here, so now students, so the translation of axis, transformation of axis. Transformation of axis. Are two types. Here one is the translation of axis. The second one, rotation of axis. Here these are the, so of course third one is the general transformation. Of course first we discussing about the translation of axis and another one is the rotation of axis. Now students, here first, so we discussing about the translation of axis. Translation of axis means, so here in this coordinate geometry, here x axis and y axis, here x dash and y dash, this is the horizon. Now, without changing the direction of the coordinate axis, the origin be shifted to the another point in that plane. Yes, this transformation is called the translation of axis. Yes, students here, so this is the new x axis and new y axis. Students, we observe this. So, without changing the direction of the coordinate axis, so the origin should be shifted to another fixed point in that plane. Here this transformation is called the translation of axis. In this, your small x x dash and y y dash, these are the old system coordinate axis and this is the old system coordinate point. Whenever the origin should be shifted to another fixed point in that plane, here small x comma small y may change in the new coordinate axis here, like capital X comma capital Y. Yes, students, here it is the origin. Yes, it is also x1, y1 is also origin in the new system. Here old system coordinate axis, here xx dash and yy dash. And the new system coordinate axis capital X X dash and capital Y Y dash here. Yes, students, we observe this. Capital X comma capital Y. Yeah, this is the coordinate point in the new system. Or the origin should be shifted to the point X1, Y1. Then small x comma small y, so shifted in the new plane as capital X comma capital Y. Yes. The relation in between these are, so small x comma small y and capital X comma capital Y and here x1 comma y1. Students, we observe this. Small x comma small y, it is a old system coordinate point. Capital X comma capital Y, new system coordinate point. Here x1 y1, that means the origin shifted to the fixed point in that plane, that is x1 comma y1. The relation between these three, here small x is equal to capital X x1 and the small y is equal to capital Y plus y1. Students, we observe this. Here we will find out the any one of the coordinate point. If any two points are given, then we will find out the any one of the coordinate point by using this relation. Here small x is equal to capital X plus x1, small y is equal to capital Y plus y1. Yes, for example, here old system coordinate points are given, and a new system coordinate, then we will finding the origin shifted to the point in that plane. Yes, for getting the x1 and y1. In this relation, to getting the x1 as x minus capital X. Here in this relation, to getting the y1 as y minus capital Y. Here students, whenever small x comma small y and x1 y1, here if both are given, then finding the new system coordinate. Yes, capital by using this relation, capital X is equals to x minus x1. Here capital Y is equals to y minus y1. Yes, if by using this relation, we will find out any one of the coordinate if any two coordinates are given. Here, students, once again, this is a translation of axis. The translation of axis means nothing but here, the translation of axis in this coordinate plane. So, without changing the direction of the coordinate axis, when the origin be shifted to another fixed point in that plane, so is called this translation is called the this transformation is called the translation of axis. In this, so we discussing only three coordinate point here: old system coordinate point and new system coordinate point, and the fixed point. That means the origin should be shifted to any one of the fixed point. Here we consider this coordinate fixed point as so x1 comma y1, or somebody consider as alpha comma beta, whatever it may be. The fixed point here x1 y1, and the old system coordinate point, and this is the new system coordinate point, and the relation between these three coordinate is given by small x is equal to capital X plus x1, small y is equal to capital Y plus y1. So students, yes, this is the another one. So the transformation of axis are the two types. One is the translation of axis, the second one is the rotation of axis. Here rotation of axis means here, so in this the origin is fixed, then the coordinate axis are rotated through equal angles. Students, we observe this. In this translation of axis, without changing the direction of the coordinate axis, the origin is shifted to the another point. But here, the origin is fixed. So, without changing the position of the origin, then the coordinate axis, here x axis and y axis, both are rotated to equal angles here. In this, x axis rotated through theta, and here also, similarly, here y axis also rotated through equal angle theta. Here this transformation is called the rotation of axis. It's quite different here. So in this, the origin is fixed, then the coordinate axis are rotated through equal angles. This transformation is called the rotation of axis. So students, here also, we are discussing small x comma small y. Yes, in this, so translation of axis, here also x comma y, old system coordinate point, and capital X comma capital Y, here new system coordinate point. But here theta is the rotating angle here. So both x axis, y axis, both are rotating equal angles. So this transformation is called the so rotation of axis. Here students, here small x comma small y, and theta, and capital X comma capital Y. Yes, the relation in between these three coordinates, yes, simply, so we can write the relation in between these three by using the sum. So table, here is a cos theta, is a minus sin theta, and sin theta, and cos theta. By using this table, yes, we can write the relation in between the old system and the new system coordinate here. Here, for getting the old system coordinate, whenever, so we know this new system and the rotating angle. Yes, small x is equals to, yes, small x is equals to x cos theta, capital X cos theta minus capital Y sin theta. Small x is equals to here, capital X cos theta plus or minus y sin theta. And small y is equals to, yes, small y is equals to capital X capital X sin theta plus capital Y cos theta. Yes friends, whenever we know this, the new variables and the rotating angle, then we will find in the own system coordinate by using this principle here. Small x is equal to x cos theta minus y sin theta, small y is equal to x sin theta plus y cos theta. Yes, similarly, so whenever we know this, the whole system and the rotating angle, then we will write the new system coordinate as capital X is equal to, students here, capital X is equal to small x cos theta plus small y sin theta. Yes, small x cos theta plus small y sin theta. And capital Y is equal to, here capital Y is equal to minus x, yes, minus x sin theta plus y cos theta. Yes, students, if we observe this, so in this rotation of axis, once again, I am repeating the definition of the rotation of axis here. So, in the coordinate plane, without changing the position of the origin, the coordinate axes are rotated through equal angles. This transformation is called the so rotation of axis. In this, old system coordinate point small x comma small y and the new system coordinate point capital x comma capital y and the theta is called the rotating angle. The relation in between these three is given by, yes, simply students, so if we observe this table, here this is the column coordinate small x comma small y, old system. In this first row, here new system, here cos theta minus sin theta, sin theta and cos theta, small x is equal to x cos theta minus y sin theta, small y is equal to x sin theta plus y cos theta. Similarly, to find out the new system coordinate as capital X is equal to x cos theta plus y sin theta, capital Y is equal to minus x sin theta plus y cos theta. Here, these are the relation between the old system, new system and the rotating angle. So students, now here, so once again, here we explain the translation of axis and the rotation of axis. Here, the translation of axis means without changing the direction of the coordinate axis, the origin shifted to the another point in that plane. Yes, the relation in between these are small x comma small y and capital X comma capital Y and here x1 comma y1 is given by, here this is the one, small x is equal to capital X plus x1, small y is equal to capital Y plus y1. Here by using this, here we have to write the remaining, here from to getting the capital X and capital Y from this, here capital X is equal to x minus x1. Here capital Y is equal to y minus y1. Yes, students, in this relation to getting the x1, y1. Yes, in this relation, x1 is equal to x minus capital X. In this relation, y1 is equal to here y minus here capital Y. Here these are the some particular relations here. Whenever we know these the two coordinate points, then we will find out the third one. Yes, small x is equal to capital X plus x1, small y is equal to capital Y plus y1. Here capital X is equal to x minus x1, capital Y is equal to y minus y1. Here x1 is equal to x minus capital X, here y1 is equal to y minus capital Y. And another one is the rotation of, it's a small, the difference between these. In this rotation of axis, here without changing the position of the origin, then the coordinate axes are rotated through equal angles. Yes, the relation between here small x comma small y and capital X comma capital Y and theta. Yes, here we observe this small x and small y, here capital X and capital Y, yes, cos theta and minus sin theta, here sin theta and cos theta. Yes, by using this table, we have to calculating the all the values here. Yes, in this small x is equals to s, small x is equal to what happened here, capital X cos theta minus capital Y sin theta, and small y is equals to, yes, small y is equals to capital X sin theta plus capital Y cos theta. Yes, capital X is equal to, we are writing the capital X here. To write that down, we have row elements here. Yes, x cos theta plus y sin theta. Yes, x cos theta plus y sin theta. And capital Y is equal to, taking the first column, this one, capital Y is equal to minus x sin theta plus y cos theta. Yes, students, here these are the synopsis of the topic transformation of axis. Once again, how many types of the transformation of axis? Translation of axis and the rotation of axis. Okay.
What is that, sir?